it's Gilles Villeneuve in pole position in the Ferrari. Alongside him, Reutemann. Then Schecter Ferrari and Depaye Ligier. Laffite Ligier and Mario Andretti in the Lotus. So, two Italian Ferraris, two French Ligiers and two British Lotuses dominate the grid for this 80-lap, 160-mile race. But as the grid forms up on the far side of the course, which is where the pits are situated, all is not well. Because there is a furious Colin Chapman, the Team Lotus owner, and Carlos Reutemann, the man who was starting on the front row of the grid, second fastest in practice. And Carlos Reutemann has had electrical trouble at the beginning of the warm-up lap, and in accordance with Formula One rules, he is being prevented from joining the grid. So the hapless Argentinian Carlos Reutemann faces the prospect, as the rest of the drivers are on their warm-up lap, of starting the race half a lap behind all of them, and nobody can give that sort of penalty away and do well against people like Jacques Laffite. They're going round to the start now, onto Shoreline Drive. They come up to the official grid, stop on the grid, wait for the red light to change to green, and then away together for 80 laps with the Queen Mary in the background there. The fastest part of the course, and up to the line they come, and Villeneuve is coming up very quickly indeed. Villeneuve has overshot. He has not stopped at the grid. And alongside him was supposed to be Reutemann. Perhaps that's confused him, but on the right in the blue and white Ligier is Patrick Depaye, who now accelerates up alongside. And Jacques Laffite, the man who won the first two races of the season, is out of his car, and from the skid marks behind, it looks as though the engine has seized up. This is real drama. This is, should have been the start. And with a car reversing back, it is all confusion at Long Beach. And now the drivers have apparently decided that they are going to head back to the pits and perhaps wait for a restart, as Jacques Laffite capitalizes on this opportunity. He's waving the tow truck up to the stricken Ligier and jumps into the pace car himself, no doubt, to go back to the pits to see if his backup car is ready. So the rest of the drivers, and this is not the race, this is the rest of the competitors heading back to the pits, which uniquely are on the far side of the course. And there is the stricken Ligier being lifted back to the pits off the course as Laffite looks for his backup car. And as the grid is reforming, there's confusion, and James Hunt, there's a rumour that Villeneuve is going to be penalised. James Hunt is there, and he'll have a view on it.
I think that the leading cars, like the pole cars, made a bit, never came under orders. He just simply didn't stop at his grid position, so he carried on, and then nobody knew what to do, and it was all good fun. But of course, what's much more fun is all the arguments now, because of course Ferrari, who spend their life shouting the rule book and claiming that they're rightfully sporting, their guy's just broken the rules inadvertently, and obviously normally we just cock up and we all come back and we race again like friends. But of course people had enough, so now people are protesting Ferrari after all their years of holier than thou, because they are actually the most unsporting team in it, and they're fighting for their life over the rule book, because theoretically Villeneuve's the pole man, he should come under orders for the start. You see, he obviously made a perfectly normal mistake, the boards weren't very clearly shown, failed to come under orders, so that technically classifies as a jump start for a minute penalty. So the Ferrari team manager is probably on the phone to Italy now asking for further instructions.
So will Gilles Villeneuve be penalised? Will he have a time penalty? Well, there's one man who's happy about the delay. It's Jacques Laffite in the backup car, as Patrick Depaye's name, which is underneath him, is taped off. The brilliant Frenchman, winner at the Argentine and the Brazil, gets ready to come out. And there is the grid, 20 minutes later, ready for the official start of the race. And here it is. And Joni Schecter surges out from behind Villeneuve. Schecter in the Ferrari, Mario Andretti well up. And they go round the right-hander at Shoreline Drive, down towards the Queen Mary hairpin. And Depaye is coming up. It is Villeneuve, and there is trouble on the first lap again. That's Patrick Tombay in the McLaren, the Frenchman Patrick Tombay in the McLaren, and he's taken off Niki Lauda with him as well. And Tombay is perfectly all right, and yet another first lap debacle. Let's have a look at it again. The two Ferraris going to the Queen Mary hairpin together with Depaye behind them. And as they do so, Patrick Tombay's McLaren rears up out of the rear of the grid onto Jan Lammers' shadow and hits Niki Lauda, the ex-world champion's V12 Brabham, and there is the red car slewing off to the left, and Niki Lauda looks as though he is out of the race already.